night was so rough. I felt like I was really being murdered. After the person that was attacking my eyes and face sent me Tom Jones Delilah videos and videos about killing someone and about their jealousy and rage, that I said something good about Vladimir Putin, believe it or not. They were attacking my face, my eyes, my back, my shoulders. I couldn't feel my hands all night. I kept telling my husband, I can't feel my hands. I can't see. And then I wake up and my eyes are burning like crazy. I'm scared to open them because I think each day I'm going to be permanently blind. But each day my vision's worse. And I've lived in this hell for years. And, but I've learned to just trust in God, you know, and keep my spirit healthy and my dreams in heaven. And now these sickos are trying to tell me they want to prostitute me or send me off with famous men to have a famous baby and be like a queen. And I'm dying inside that I'm surrounded by all these losers. I'm dying. I'm really dying. It's killing me. It really is. It's killing me because I had substance before these people came. I had worth. I saw heaven on earth. I saw angels. I saw beauty. I believed in love. I had my sacred universe with God who gave me all the love I needed, all the consolement, all the visions. And these devils hacked my brain and got inside and destroyed me to try to make me so I had no comfort zone. So all the suffering went to the Antichrist. So everything they destroyed went to Satan. So that I could no longer see the world as a positive place. These monsters are lust puppies and demons, and they created hell on earth. Love to them is a big bank account. I was blessed my whole life to have love and to have good guidance. I had heavenly advisors. My mom was my best role model, and she suffered greatly. She was so selfless. She would put always food on the table for everyone else, and she didn't care if she ate or not. And if everyone got as much as they wanted, and if there was not enough at the end, she would just not eat or get something like a bowl of soup or something. She would never do anything for herself. If I gave her money, she would never buy herself something. She would go buy things for animals, needy animals. She'd rescue cats and dogs. She would buy shelter for them, bird feeders, bird seed. I mean, my mom was not indulged on, but oh my God, she people like her, they have the greatest heart. They're givers. They're selfless. And she died. And my friend, Sister Alawinia, she spent her whole life serving others in poverty. God touched her. My whole family was givers. And they were not, predators. They didn't go to school and learn how to be a lawyer. They didn't learn how to be phony. You know, the people that are trying to redesign me are not making it. They're faking it. I came from a real place with real substance, with kind people, with angels from God, angels and God working through people. I saw God through them. I saw God every day through my family. I saw God through Sister Alawinia. I saw God working through Father Varen. I see God and the Holy Spirit and the most infinite power in the eyes of a newborn baby. God is not in those people that are building those dark buildings, that are having sex with everyone in sight. I feel so sad for the group Paris Jackson's gotten with. That poor child was never allowed to find love. And they're trying to pair up with these men and trying to get her to have sex. And they're saying in the tabloids, oh, she's in love with this person. They're corrupting people. They're exploiting people. They're keeping them from reality. And even using sex to make money. This is all the devil, nothing else. And I've told them all along, you don't know me. If I'm a creative visionary when I'm with God, and with God, God showing me things. And that was my sacred universe that would blew this world away. That was something you keep in the hereafter, that connection with the divine and the universe and your soul and the celestial galaxy. That is something we were born with, that is our heaven, our sanctity, our soul. And that was my hereafter, and they tried to keep me from that world with God, and they tried to block his messages to me. I'm a receiver. They tried to prevent him from talking to me. He told me what they were about. I saw right through them. He told me their weakness. He told me they will fall because they have no substance. The sacred things, the special things, the holy things, the earthen things, the heavenly things are the only thing that make life worthwhile. When I had love my whole life, I had all I needed in existence. When I had respect, when I had a healthy home, you know, a beautiful outside environment, just through nature, trees, birds, that were a clean environment. I had a place to go play as a kid, a flood wall. I could play by the river. I had it made. I had a heaven on earth. Do you think those tribes years ago had to have all this modern bullshit? It's killed people. It's corrupted the soul. There isn't even good modern music anymore. I guess in a way I have enlightened, because if I hear songs now, I want to puke. And when these Mel Admirers send me shit on the internet, these songs, I want to throw up. I'm like, you people are so programmed to like garbage. This whole world was now created off garbage. The good things of long ago are being destroyed. The legends of long ago are dying. All the real depth and spiritualism and realism is being replaced by crooks and devils and gluttons and whores and fools, absolute fools. When I was young, all the kids wanted to come that were in my neighborhood to be with my family because they were lacking love. And I remember when I was little, even in middle school, my mom would go to school with me. She loved me that much. We had such a closeness. She would go to school with me, or someone would always be there to pick me up. I never had to leave the school my whole childhood and not have loving arms, a nice snack when I got home, or some special thing to do with my family. Something that made me feel very special and in my own little sacred world and perfect holy nest. It was all love, nothing else. I was never abused by my parents, never. And to me, that you can't get a better life than that. You really can't. So when I got older, I had wrote my whole life. I felt I got my visions through God. And then I decided I'd start opening up and share them. And you know, there was a warning in me that said, don't become worldly, Sherry. Don't share that. It's sacred to you. It comes from someplace high. Don't let people know what your closeness is to God. It's cheapening you. If you talk to the spirits and they give you messages, angels, don't tell anybody, because it's cheapening you. You're sharing it with the world, and the world destroys things. It's true. I've tarnished my soul. I let predators in. I'll never win. I don't know if I'll ever be close again to God in the way I want to be, and I don't even know if I'm even going to go to heaven. These people have surrounded me. They've used sheep machines to drain my vision, my mind, destroy my brain. They said they think I had a third eye. I've got psychic power, and I've got telekinesis, because either that or it's the spirits. When I get upset, water can gush from the faucet, lights will flicker on and off. They said I have that, but I think it's maybe, I don't know if I have it or not, I really don't. They said I have more energy than anyone they've seen. They said, and someone said Elvis had energy, but they said I could destroy the world if I wanted to with energy. I have God, and these people don't. And so they're dissecting me and killing me because they think it's power. What they have is evil. Evil is all. Love is power. God is power. And they've turned me into garbage. They've destroyed everything that was original. They've even destroyed my mind, where I can't even get good creative ideas. They tried to destroy my self-worth through God's love. They've tried to make me so broken that I'll feel like even God can't love me. They've tried to destroy my relationship with my husband, so I feel like nobody loves me. I know I'm loved, but I don't feel that I'm lovable. I don't feel I'm worthy, because I'm the kind of person that when I had the best there was to offer and the good things, I was never satisfied with loving people because I never felt good enough. I didn't. And now, you know, with all their insults and stuff, I don't feel good. And the whole thing was just to cheapen me, to try to make me a prostitute for them, to try to make me a product, to try to make me perform. They want commodities. They want trash. They want sleaze. They don't want love. They don't want godliness. They don't want substance. And now I just cry at night, holding on to what brain I have left, as they destroy my memories, telling me they don't want my memories because it's not a part of their productive slave empire. And I just know heaven existed once, and reality was heaven on earth, and God was here. And it gets darker each day as they take more of that away from me. And now they think they can rape me with a bunch of men, put me with famous men, and all of a sudden they'll get something out of me. Or they think they can have a baby to experiment on. They never looked into my soul. They never asked me what was important to me or cared about what mattered to me. And that connection I had with God was so strong that if I asked him anything, he'd give it to me. He'd let me, and he gave me a great mom, a great family, so much love and protection and shelter and heavenly memories and good inspiration for heaven above, that all I did was look for heaven to be reunited with my loved ones. And that was the only keepsake I have to keep me going in life, the only spark. When I looked up in the stars, the only stars I could dream about were the heaven that I would once have again with the people that were from my life. I wanted to be reunited. I wanted to go to that place. And the night that I felt like Christ was in me, this white light appeared, and I was up somewhere in the heavens or the galaxy, and I was with all these other white lights. And I know I was with my mother. She was there. She was like inside of me too, glowing bright. We were all glowing as one big powerful light, a unity in the galaxy. And I know that she was pure. Her soul was light. It was the most pure light you could ever see. So much substance. And I just felt like I'll never find that here. I'll look. I'll never be fulfilled. I'll never find substance. Once you know God, and you've had God inside you working miracles, making tornadoes have come on my street right beside me, lifting up the rooftops of my old house, throwing the posts everywhere, and you stand there and God blesses you and saves you. And then you're going to have a car accident and he tells you beforehand, put your seatbelts on. You don't know that the road's slick up ahead, and you do. Or he sends you a dove. You know God's watching over you and he's always protecting you. He has higher purpose for you in a higher place in the heavens. That's why he gave you that substance. You know there's a mission and you're working miracles, and every day there's miracles through God and he shows you. But this group comes along and they darken the world and you don't hear about the miracles anymore. And you see all these babies crying and you see the substance disappear. And then you know your faith is important, because the only dreams that matter are in the higher place, wherever we go after here, because there won't be anything of substance here anymore. All the good things are being taken away. All the spiritualism and holiness and love, they want to shatter that. And if people are running around in black, dressed like it's Halloween, wearing all these weird Halloween get-ups, what the hell do they think they're playing with? Oh my God, they've condemned me, destroyed my heart, destroyed my mind. That's no kind of future. So whenever I create It's with God and the angels and total solitude. It was spent on my land where I'm surrounded by nature. Nature brings angels to you. All sorts of sweet angels. Nature brings that to me. And then here I had the stars at night. I had a loving husband. I was in ultimate peace. And I created my house where it had windows where I always felt like I could look into the heavens from whatever room I was in. And I would let my mind go there. And I've been to, I think, 54 countries, counting layovers, my husband's counted. And I never felt my place. I liked Australia, but I never felt a total unity and peace and creative power and energy like I felt here with God. I know God's everywhere, but it's not the same. Here I had all the elements I needed to have the most creative power, because I could see the snow every winter and know God was talking to me. I could go outside and talk to him and it felt like he would make the wind blow. I had angels here. I have an animal habitat with berries and everything for birds and tons of raccoons and foxes. All the animals have come here in the 25 years we've been here, and they love it here. It's been a little bit less than 25 years. And because I've drawn all those good energies, and we've had animals our whole life, over 15 dogs, and a lot of them are buried here after they die. Because of that, I created my own heaven on earth, to where I got nothing but spiritual power and creative energy. And these people came and destroyed it with their weapons, their mind experiments, their dark military and their army that came here on my land and hid, their evil devil worshipers that left dead mice in my home and pelvic tweezers and did all these rituals around my house. They came and tried to destroy paradise. And these are the people that want to destroy paradise on the whole planet. And they don't understand what moves me, what my visions are, where I want my heart and soul to go. They don't know the godliness I once had and the peace.